But first, if you've been people watching lately, you see plenty of folks walking or running around with headphones, listening to music, podcasts, live streaming, Seven Sharp even. But what they're also likely to be doing is damaging their ears.
The National Foundation for Deaf and Hard of Hearing has launched a pilot study into high school kids as they try to get to grips with the alarming rate of hearing loss in young people. Here's Carolyn Robinson.
And music. Not a new relationship, but as the technology has progressed, so has the problem. The World Health Organization now says one in five youths has some form of hearing loss.
We have seen a 30% increase since the 1990s, and WHO attribute that to personal device use. So we're talking to kids at some of the schools and they've got their headphones on all day, 12 hours a day. All the time and right up until bedtime, like they're using them until they go to sleep.
So the National Foundation for the Deaf has begun a five-year study beginning with two Auckland high schools, and early results are not good.
We tested at Rutherford College and we found around 12% of Year 9 students to have hearing loss. At Manurewa we've started hearing screening checks there and we're currently seeing levels of 30%.
The WHO reckons 1.1 billion people are at risk of losing their hearing because of headphone use, and the majority of those are teens.
Hearing loss was attributed more to an ageing demographic, so you think about the young kids that are coming through with hearing loss, what's the impact going to be in terms of society, them leading a fulfilling life, how we geared up to support those kids coming out of school.
So what can we do to protect our kids' hearing? Check their ears.
I think the first step is getting a hearing check, but also understanding what good hearing health is, making sure you don't have wax build-up. A lot of the kids may not necessarily understand the signs of having hearing loss. So some of the kids might be mentioning that they have ringing in the ears or sore ears, and those are related to tinnitus and can be related to hearing loss.
Turn it down.
You need to make sure that when you're listening to headphones that they're at a safe sound level, so below 80 decibels or below the halfway mark. If you can hear your children's noise levels through headphones, that means it's too loud. They need to turn it down.
And listen less.
Research suggests that you should limit your use of headphones to no more than 90 minutes a day.
There'll be a lot of people listening to that that are blowing that big time.
Absolutely, and I guess what I say to these kids out there and parents is that you need to protect your hearing because once it's gone, it is gone and you can't get it back.
ASB and 7 Sharp, keeping you one step ahead.
So under 24-year-olds, twice as likely to suffer from hearing loss than the generation before them. But the National Foundation for Deaf and Hard of Hearing, yes, they have a new name, well spotted, wants more schools involved for that study so you can get in touch with them if you're keen. You wear headphones a lot?
Yes, well, I wear headphones on the radio, on Radio Hauraki in the mornings for 3 hours, really loud. Also, I wear AirPods when I'm running. Mm. And I used to go to dance parties, I think, when I was younger, listen to very loud music, and my hearing's not great, to be honest. It's definitely affected my hearing.
Yeah, we get yelled at a lot through these. See, we have, these are comms that go through to the... and they yell at us. So it's just yelling at me now.
Yeah.
And I'm probably going to lose my hearing. It's funny, I think that you might have a little bit of a hearing problem, because sometimes I find in the afternoon that you don't seem to hear a lot of the things that I'm saying to you.
No, I can hear you. I just decide not to listen. It's a completely different thing.